Okay, so I'm just running Burns-O-Matic 8000 and 4000 facing each other, which is propane. And I'm doing some bongs like that. I'm doing bongs like just big bubbles, whatever I want to do. Whatever I want to do. Here's some spoons with color. What I'm going to do for you today is going to be just color, but it's not going to be that big because those take me like 45 minutes to do. A lot of color. A lot of scrap glass. Been doing this a year with just propane. All self-taught. Here we go. Those are the best way to break glass, right there. Well, tubing, just small tubing like this. Red, yellow, and orange. Got pre-cold, like all the rest of these guys. Right here.
graphite to do that. You put these marks. Drag it now, probably two up, two down, let's see. I always mess up on spacing them, I always want to make sure I space them right, so they look right, perfect drags. I'm going to make sure the other side's cool, because from throwing this in the heat, it'll heat up the other side, because the tubing's so small, they want to blow on it a few times, which I do to make sure it's not soft, so it doesn't fold over on itself. You don't want that. The hotter you get your stick you're dragging with, usually clear. You can drag with any color you want, but the hotter you have it, the more clear you leave behind. It gives an effect on the piece. That's pretty cool. Makes it look in-depth. Like the drag you did, you can drag it again. The trick is to get everyone uniform perfect, but that's pretty tough to do. It's a lot of time practice. Smooth, not slow down and stop like I almost did. If you get stuck, stop, just let it cool down and break it off. There's no point in keep pulling it, so leave it there and let it cool down. One point goes all the way to the end and the color drags all the way through, you want all of them too, because you want to keep the glass nice and even. You'll have to pain in the ass later, and you won't like the piece anyways when you're done with it. Get off all the stringies again if there are any. Journey. back your tails that you left behind from dragging it. You can redo them. You can touch them all up. Make them look even, however you want. If the stick ain't hot enough, it comes off the glass, it'll nail you. Like that. I could do this however I want to. I could twist it however many way I want. You just want to keep it blown out so it doesn't have the big wrinkles in it, so the heat can get to the into the creases. But it's just a learning process, and when you twist the glass while blowing, it leaves just the color blown. But if you just twist it without blowing in it, it leaves the glass twisted like that. You can do any kind of size twist you want to do. I'm just going to twist the color on the outside, give it some, a little more creative fire off. Pull this tip off because I want the glass there. I don't want the, I want the color to stay in. It needs to be thick.
Spiral of the show, but you want to leave all the excess tip there because when it melts back down, it creates a really cool effect on the glass.
but it has its setbacks and it has its advantages. The big one is price. It's price effective, that's for sure. Mixing up the color and putting it on there.
color is going to come out of it when it cools down, but I'm not going to say or make it perfect. I'm just going to do a bowl push and carb real quick.
To get to this point took me a long, well, less than like 5 months, but a lot of trial and error because I'm self-taught, so. I know a lot of tricks and techniques that I never see anybody do on videos or show anybody, so I'll probably keep doing more videos. I should. I'm gonna pick this. If my torch ain't hot enough, so I don't sit there and blow a bubble. If I do, it'll be the hugest hole ever, so I pick it. Which is that, it's pulling a spike. I snip it off. Biggest issue for me, bowl push. It's been a problem for a while, but I'm starting to get more and more come out perfect. My torch flame can't hit the bottom, so once you have it pushed in there, it kind of set where it's at. I'm gonna do it right the first time, so. Grab something very fine, whatever I find, and center it back out. Side you want it on. I'm trying to do a lot better job, but I'm just trying to do it one under 30 minutes. So that's the carb, the hole, flat bottom.
That's a half hour for me to do this. I'm trying to cool down so you see colors before the video's over. But to do a quality, heady one takes me a good hour. It's not efficient for making money, but you could try. You could definitely learn. But you see colors coming out more and more. Here's Cormezzi and how I'd be doing it. Thanks.